Alrighty then, good afternoon to you. Welcome to the final day of the Under 18 Ice Hockey World Championships. It's Division 3B action, which we will see from the GrandWest Ice Rink. My name is Jeremy Harris, alongside my partner in crime, Nadine Sheffield, as we get ourselves ready for the final day's action. Can't believe we are here already.
It's crazy. I miss having the long tournaments, but 3 days is... It's too short, man.
Yeah, no, I'm just getting warmed up now, and they're telling me it's all over. Listen, of course, non-stop action nonetheless. We've seen lots of great ice hockey over the last few days. Today is, of course, the final day's action. And as I said, lots of action. Let's see what it looks like from a point-standing perspective. Let's see where the various teams sit at the moment. There we go. Hong Kong, China certainly have looked the business. Two wins from two outings. They're going to want to make it a clean sweep today, make no mistake. They're up against Thailand in a short while, and looking forward to that. Turkmenistan are second, alongside Thailand, who, of course, are on a slightly more expanded goal difference. And then South Africa learning their way through the world of ice hockey. Of course, there is another game later on this evening. It's all about the South Africans, and lots of people will flood their way into this venue as South Africa take on Turkmenistan. It's only pride to play for, but I tell you what, pride is a massive motivator. And as I said, that one gets underway at 7:30. Looking forward to lots of people and lots of bums in seats here at GrandWest, but also, of course, on our stream as well. Let's have a look at what the teams look like for today's encounter as the teams pile onto the ice here. Here we go. That is the Thailand team. Some really good skaters amongst them. Players to watch for some senior ice hockey drills in the future. That's Thailand. Let's have a look at what Hong Kong, China looks like. There we go. Really good players. And both those goalkeepers, by the way, really looking good as well. They've been very, very impressive as we get ourselves ready for a face-off.
So the officials for tonight, we have Oscar Utsvedal from Norway. He's the referee on the ice there with the red armbands. And the lines person, we have Michael Christensen from Denmark and Vit Lederer from Czech Republic.
There we go. We are literally seconds from that puck drop. These are two really good teams, Nadine Sheffield.
Yeah, they are. This is going to be... quite a game to watch, actually. Both these teams have got precision passing, super speed, good control, good stick handling. It's actually one of the games that I'm actually most looking forward to, actually. It's like...
it's a guy...
on top of the net.
Top of the net, I like it.
Doing a referee thing.
He's not going to miss the team talk, that's a fact.
Oh, my word, that's
okay,
funny.
Listen, good to have you along if you are watching...
from this angle.
...my streaming services. There we go. Let's see him get back off there. Oh, no problem. Straight off there.
Just don't cut the net.
No problem at all. There we go. Of course, we're at the... Well, I'll tell you what, your timing is absolutely impeccable as you come back for the very first goal. We had a couple of technical gremlins to get things underway. It's what happens when you let Nadine Sheffield press buttons in the studio. She sometimes presses the wrong one. Apologies for that.
It wasn't me.
Okay, might have been me. But I'll tell you what, as I said, timing spot on as we come back for a goal. Literally as you came back to us. In fact, here's the replay of it. Thailand with the goal. nicely dealt with initially, and then on the rebound, thanks for coming, and good night. The first strike there for Thailand. Got to tell you, Hong Kong, China will not be happy with that. They've certainly been the form team. They've had a couple of slow starts, but then have been able to weather it. So maybe that's another way. Maybe they just start slowly and then they finish really strong. Tananuch Kultantorn, the skipper of that strike, and a very valuable one, may very well prove very useful at the end if it goes to a Thailand win. But we've still got lots of ice hockey before then. And what we've seen from Hong Kong, China, is a team that is very composed. So they're not going to be flustered by an early goal against them. In fact, they've had that all tournament long. They've had to come back, and then they've come back really strongly.
Yeah. As I say, I was saying that I'm really excited to watch this game. So, yeah, it's a great start. It was in the first few minutes of the period that Thailand put one away. So it's going to be a good battle between these two teams. I think they're fairly evenly matched skill-wise. But let's see who's going to want it more and come out on top. Hong Kong, China definitely on the top at the moment, but let's see if Thailand can upset them. Right now the play is down in the Thailand zone. Good battles going on the boards there. Here comes a shot, deflected out there by number 16 from Thailand. Kut with it now, Kut with a shot, deflected out by the keeper. The keeper in the net for the Thailand team right now is their number one, and that's Vijak Nyomvong. And the keeper for Hong Kong China is Taz Wing David Lam, number one. Some good battles going on there in the boards. And Thailand coming away with it. Pops it up, but just too fast, but they're getting some necessary changes. Good battle there, and Thailand winning it, but Hong Kong stealing it away. Hong China with a breakout through the middle. Great defensive work there by the Thai team. He's going to go for icing though. Break now, number 10. Oh, good poke check there by the Hong Kong China defenseman.
I like the crisp, precise passes. Oh, my word. That was an absolute body check. I mean, feet up.
Giving an interference call there. Mr. Referee. And that is the number 10 for Thailand that's going to go sit in the penalty box and think of it. And that is Natipaj Pananare.
He upended the Hong Kong China number 8. I think it was Ari Luing. If we're able to see that again in replay, you'll see what an absolute thud of a check it was.
No, I just missed it, but I will see it again. Face off, one there by the Hong Kong China team. Chung with it now, back to Wong. Wong to the defenseman up there, to Kut. Good passing there, keeping it wide.
And keeping possession, you know. In comes the shot.
And it's in!
Deflections and goal!
It's in! Beautiful work there for a power play. That is a pristine power play there.
Yep, absolutely.
Hong Kong, China on the board. There's a replay.
Let's have a look at it again. You see, well, before that, they were holding on to the position, fired it in, and not able to hold on to it, the keeper. And goal time, 1-1 now, the score between Hong Kong, China and Thailand. And that's exactly what we were saying. They start slowly, but, you know, they don't get flustered. And then they come back with a strong performance. Let's have a look at this. This is what I was talking about, Nadine. Have a look at this body check. Bang!
Oh, yeah.
And he is flat on his back.
The puck was long gone.
Yes. Here we go. Face of time as we get the game underway. Hong Kong, China definitely are meaning business. But wow, good performances as well. Yeah, good pressure coming from Thailand. In comes the shot, deflected off the keeper. Not too sure that he knew too much about it, but he got his body in the way anyway, and was able to nudge it off to his left-hand side.
So the goal there was scored by number 17, Owen Kwok, and assisted by number 5, who is Manhin Tommy Kut. So that was a great goal there.
It's really good defense there at a crucial moment there as Thailand took the shot. Good defense there from Hong Kong, China.
Ooh,
but it's Hong
pass.
Kong, China with the shot now. Wow. Well, they've certainly saved the best for last. I mean, this is their final game of the tournament. Ooh. Another serious body check, but that nobody had a problem with.
Ouch.
Yes, other than ouch.
It's getting a bit physical for these two teams.
I was about to say, it's...
old rivals.
It's a physical old affair. Good composure there from Thailand, looking for a way through. Just nudges it down and around the boards, looking up for some support. Thailand gets it away. They still have position. Not too sure that they meant to do that.
I think these two teams also meet in the Asia Cup, and they often, I mean, so they obviously play a lot together against each other, a lot more than like South Africa gets to play against anybody. So it's nice. They've probably got a good competition going, and it's always a nice rivalry, you know. And this is the one for the gold medal, you know, in this tournament, but not this game specifically. But, I mean, Thailand's looking to upset Hong Kong, China, because they're the strongest team right now.
And
let's have an upset.
Look at that. Up the ice. I wanted to say interference, but I didn't mean interference illegally. What I meant was just really good... defensive work there from Thailand. Now, can they work their way up? Nope. Pushed off the puck by Hong Kong, China. Now, it's still Hong Kong, China with possession. What to do with it? Set it up for the second phase. Now, just this is the composure that I spoke about. They're good at holding on the second. We need to get ourselves a steady platform to build off. And until they do that, they're not going to be taking any risks. They look for how they can set it up an attacking position, and then they go.
I wish you had seen yesterday's game.
Yeah.
When Hong Kong China was playing, they almost did, before every single goal, 3 passes. It was literally like, let's practice this, get our quick passes, give and goes, and a strike in. But that was also the only way they could almost score against the Turkmenistan goalie, because he was so flipping good. So it was such a different tactic, and I mean, it's just beautiful to watch such good passing.
That was a very late body check by Lam on his opposite number. Official was right there, didn't think that anything was wrong.
Depends if it was the official with the bands, I didn't see it. Was it the referee? We'll see now. Oh yeah, he was there, and he did shout at them, but I think it was a... I don't know why he didn't give them a...
Let's have another look at that last goal, just a different angle. Shot comes in, you can see it's like a bullet, and it bobbles all over the place.
Oh, wow.
Keeper just couldn't hold on to it.
It actually looked like it came off number 2 there, but I don't know. I have no idea if that was the right call for my side.
All that matters is that it's a goal. It went across the goal line, and it's now 1-1. To be fair, Thailand haven't given up either. They are still very much into this. Yes, they've given back a goal, but it's not over yet.
I think this is going to be a pretty competitive game throughout, actually.
You think so? You don't think it's going to be a big score?
No.
Okay, here we go. Nadine Sheffield has experienced eyes.
Maybe getting up 5, but I'm thinking it's going to be 1-1, 1-1. We'll see. It depends. Anything can change, because once a couple goes go in for one team, you saw how
shot
it sometimes
comes in around
changes.
The back.
South Africa also. Once it goes in, sometimes you just lose it after that. Your morale goes down. You lose your composure. But these two teams seem to be very strong-headed in that respect. So we'll see how it goes.
Fresh legs on the ice for Thailand. It's Hong Kong, China, though. They come away with the puck, with the position, up the ice. In it comes, looking for a way to get it through. Just miscued that one there. There we go. This is what I'm talking about. This is the platform that they build in will come the shot, and looking for it to get through there. Still, it's a little bit of a mess inside the goal area, but it's Hong Kong China now that will rebuild.
Oh, but the pressure's there. The pressure's there. Tyler is definitely looking to.
And that's also a lesson, Nadine, that South Africa need to learn is to pressure.
So when I was chatting here with Ian last night, then I also said yesterday, that's just, it explains a lot.
Shows how much you missed me.
Anyway, so there was this one kid from South African team that he kept on saying his job and what he loves to do is put on the back check and the forecheck. And he's always putting pressure on, hassling the other teams. And he was on the ice, and when he got a penalty, you could see it was just disappeared.
Yeah.
So it's interesting to watch. Some of the players really do love doing that forecheck and attacking. Others are just like, meh. So it is a learning thing. I think every team has to put out 100% sprinting as they get on the ice. I think that's the best thing to do. Just on 9 minutes and 16 seconds left in the period. 4 shots to 3, but the score is even. Here we go. Face off down in the Hong Kong China zone. Let's see who wins it. And that's Thailand that wins that face off. Oh, he wanted to wind up for a big one there. And his teammate stole it from him. Shame. Maybe it was a tactic fake. Thailand managing to keep hold of it. Offside. Good call. One backwards by the Hong Kong China team. Passed through the middle, but it's kept in the zone. No, it came off the Hong Kong China team. Anyway, it is an offside call. Goalie looks like he's taking a chill. Relaxing there. He's winning the face-off. Hong Kong, China wins the face-off, but Thailand sneaks it away.
Thailand's just the shortest of short, or longest of long sticks.
Oh. Was that a sniper? Thailand managing to get possession. Can they get one in? Good pressure there by the Hong Kong, China team, and they've managed to get a possession. Now they're taking it up. Hong Kong, China losing it in the neutral zone.
Shot comes in. And you know, it's going to be interesting, as you say, you think it's going to be a tight affair. You may very well be right, because I'm not sure that Hong Kong, China are used to this level of physicality against them. And to have their space cut down as much as they have been. Ooh, that one went almost the wrong way.
Kept out there. Keeper number one.
Good skating, wow, and good stick work. Up the ice go Thailand. He must have beaten about three
offside.
Players. And
he dropped it back just too soon. Damn. Bad timing, Shane. Maybe he was...
I mean, that was a split second too soon. Anyway, what I was saying was that, there's a lot of pressure, a lot of space that a really good team like Hong Kong China can create for themselves. But I think because maybe the Thailand team play against them fairly often and they see them, they know them, there's a little bit more comfort playing against them, they close down those spaces.
Yeah, they do. I think obviously both coaches, sets of coaches, have been watching how the teams have progressed through the tournament, and now they've obviously got an idea of how they play, more familiar with this team, because there could be a bunch of rookies that they haven't played against before. So I think it could come down to like really good game changing tactics per period after they've had a discussion in the change room. Because right now, it's very even.
It is. It's very even. And Hong Kong, China are not having their own way. Look at that. I mean, just taken away from them by Thailand. It's at this stage anybody's game. Two good teams up against each other, and nobody's giving an inch.
No, at all. They're both really good at putting pressure on and quick moving.
Good stick work. I love watching that. But sorry, closed out and blocked out by Thailand, who come up the ice. That was a bit of a knee in there. Time for number three, Rex Koo. He'll go and spend a bit of time.
What is he getting it for? Cross-checking.
I said a knee.
You did say a knee. I was hoping he was going to call your way. I'm trying to train you.
It looked like
a
knee.
But I didn't see what actually
happened.
One
day I will also be an official, just like you.
We must.
A super official.
You know I'm recruiting, right?
Are you the recruiting officer?
Well, I'm trying.
Okay.
Here we go.
I mean, it's taken me this long to become a commentator, so I mean, can you only imagine how long it's going to be before I can actually ref a game? Good grief.
Ref from up here. So we have just under 2 minutes left. Oh, that's like pointless saying that. But anyway, so Hong Kong, China shorthanded. Let's see how Thailand can put together a good power play if they can do the same thing that Hong Kong, China did earlier.
Mm.
But you see the pressure difference between the Hong Kong, China team.
That went all the way through.
They're putting pressure on straight away, making them force the move right now. Straight away, two away. Good
this
tactic.
Is a different game plan from Thailand. They are here to unsettle Hong Kong, China as much as they possibly can. I mean, I don't have the stats, but it feels to me like more than 50% of the game has been played inside the Hong Kong, China half of the ice.
No, definitely. So that penalty was for Xing Yu Rex Ku, number three, and that was for cross-checking.
It looked like there was a knee in there, which is why I called a knee, but I mean, happy
it's
to accept
possible.
That.
I don't know if we got a replay on it, but here we go.
Let's have a quick look
just
at what...
Just for you. Or for me. Or for you.
Face-off time, though. It's deep inside Thailand's red zone, and Thailand come away with it.
Just on 5.5 minutes left in this period.
That's the other thing. When the game flies by, then you know it's a good game.
It's been flowing nicely, actually.
Yep. Keen to see that that penalty where Rex Koo went to go and spend some time in the sin, but in fact he's still there. Another 38 seconds. Ping-pong all over the place.
It looked like snooker.
Yeah.
Big pass up to the cherry picker.
And space and
save. Oh, great save. But you see, again, that's Hong Kong, China have been doing that. They've been putting a cherry picker. But what's weird is they're doing it even when they're shorthanded. They're moving like a synchro team right now. Everything is just perfectly synced. I love watching the way they play.
Wow, their long-range shots are so good.
Thailand, yeah.
Sniping. Anyway. Hong Kong, China have weathered the storm. In fact, they almost scored a goal on the power play. But now full strength. Oh, and another miscue. Otherwise, who knows what that score would have been. But it's Hong Kong, China who come away with it up the ice. Numbers are all even. Score is all even, at least for the time being. Nice inside-outside there. Dink. From Thailand as they go up the ice all on their own. Shot comes in.
Ding. That's as bad as me and my misconduct call. Ding.
Looking for a way through. Maybe just a bit too much zip on that pass, but still lots of questions being asked by Thailand. But for now, it's Hong Kong, China trying to make a way through up the ice, and they come away with it. It's just the keeper to beat. In comes the shot.
And it's so close, but it just trickled past the post at the bottom.
Did he get his glove to it or his jersey?
It kind of looked like under his arm jersey, and then it just dropped down and went blip, past the post.
I think he missed it in terms of getting it with his hand or with his glove, and as a result, his jersey, sort of the webbing under his arm on the jersey, pulled it down, and it literally just dropped to the ground.
Puck out of bounds.
Let's have a look at this one, Nadine. See what you think.
This is the shot. Yeah, just under his
under the armpit.
Oh, and it was right by the post.
He's going to claim it, though. He's going to claim it as he should. Another great save.
Very, very close. Oh, with it. Just goes over. Wong dumps it in. Oh, he's going to pick it up. He's so small, he takes on that big guy.
Wow. P-car traffic on the other side of the ice at the moment as Thailand come away with it.
Number 23 dumping it down, looking for his partner to chase on the opposite side. Great tactic there. Just didn't quite get on his stick, but he's making sure he's got that. Still trying to battle it up, but Hong Kong China coming away with it. 2-on-2. Shot down low.
Great shooting.
Good hassling there. Number 22 picking up speed, chasing it through. Four of them just closing him down. He has nowhere to move.
I mean, that is so good. How they're able to get back so quickly.
I told you, it's like a synchro team, hey? They just move together as a unit. Beautiful.
I mean, actually, one minute they're up attacking, next minute they're back defending, and it's almost like...
The back check is brilliant. And I was actually chatting to a little Deline Rode, who plays on the national team for the South African women.
Yeah, yeah.
And we were saying, she was just saying how much she loves watching these Asian teams play and the way they skate.
Look at this.
The way they move. Look at the precision.
That was beautiful.
Literally smiles on our faces the whole way through watching these guys play.
I mean, these are like...
Pretty.
These are like figure skaters who are playing ice hockey.
Yeah, so figure skaters with a chip on their shoulder.
Yeah, and with a helmet on their head. And
big
in comes
shot,
the shot. Wow.
Very high.
He's not going to want to see that in the highlight reel.
Some changes coming here. Here we go. Hong Kong, China looking for a new way to get up.
We're into the last few, literally seconds, 80 seconds of the first period.
It's so quiet out there.
And I'm going to give it to Thailand, this first period. I'm going to give it to Thailand. Yes, there's been some really good hockey. Of course, they did score the first goal as well. But I think on balance, for me, the judges would have to give it on points to Thailand if this was a boxing match.
I agree, but also looking at Hong Kong, China, they've got more shots on net than Thailand have had.
Yep.
They're trying to get up there, but they just can't seem to break through the red wall.
And literally, there is a red wall. I promise you, their back checking is really good. Very efficient, very composed, and almost impossible to get through.
With the shot.
Shot comes
down
in.
Low, looked after in that
did
glove.
He snap that up with his hand just like that?
Yes, he did.
That is ridiculous. That is just ridiculous. You have got to see that skill. I mean,
it
casual as you like, walking down the street. He snaps it up on the half volley.
That was very pretty.
Let's have a look at this one. Watch this. It's definitely going to trouble him. And in it comes. And thanks for coming. Thank you. I'll just snap this up, put it in my pocket, and off to go. I'm out of here. Wow. When you're good like that, you're just good like that.
Yeah, that's true. Really, really nice. Here we go. Number 3 with it, winning it back to his teammate, but getting through his legs. Hong Kong, China still keeping it down low. 17 seconds left. Good battle on the corner. They're still managing to keep it down in the Thailand zone.
Chasing. There's still 8 seconds to go.
And we got a
hold
penalty
on a
coming.
Second. We are going to have ourselves
elbowing. Woo! Number 8 for Thailand going in the box there for elbowing.
I love how when they get sent to the sin bin. Yeah, this door over here, the one that's open.
You're on this side now. Tito Wat Porta Masaku.
Very good work. It's 7 seconds. And there's a face of deep inside the Thailand red zone. I mean, I've seen stranger things in ice hockey. We could still see a goal. And
they've done it before. They've managed to clear it. Well,
now
done.
We will see nothing other than
that
little buzzer. That's the only thing we'll see.
That's first period, 1-1. Nicely even game. I'm really...
I feel like somebody hit the fast forward button because that 20 minutes flew by. Make no mistake, it was gone in a flash. The score, though, 1-1. It suggests that Hong Kong China did most of the work with 8 goals against... 8 shots at goal, rather, as opposed to the 5 from Thailand. 1-1 is the scoreline. And we head into the break. And, of course, 15 minutes or so away from the start of the second period. I was saying to Nadine Sheffield, my thoughts are that even though it appears as if Hong Kong China did the most of the work, gosh, I really do feel like, on measure, it's Thailand who had the better of that that first period. Yeah. Let's see. Of course, there's no on measure anything. It's you either winning or you're not winning. And they've got 2 more periods of ice hockey to get ourselves a result out of this one. It's not the game, I think, that Hong Kong China were expecting. They have certainly been the form team of this tournament. But, wow, they have come up against a stiff and tough opponent in this game.
And their goal average, I mean, they've had, like, really high, like, scoring goals as well. So
Helpyourself.com.
This is not normal for them to be, you know, 1-1.
Nope.
It's very different for them. So we'll see how it's going to come out. I think both of them are going to come out firing. We're just going to have to see who got the biggest screaming at the
Exactly. Listen, Nadine Sheffield has slipped some brandy and coffee into the commentary box. And so I'm going to have some of that while she tells you about all of our wonderful sponsors.
Alrighty, so yeah, shout out to all the sponsors that make this possible for us, because in this beautiful city, this beautiful arena, you know, we can't say anything but thank you. Really, really thank you. Signage Hub, Bloberg Meats, DigiCape, Intro, CFW Fans, Peninsula Beverages, the Department of Sports, Arts and Culture, Western Cape Government, City of Cape Town, South African Ice Hockey Federation, SASCOC, Western Province Ice Hockey Association, Sun GrandWest, The Ice Station, Red Mountain, Heart FM, Pedigree Media, Graphic Thought Design, TLC, Catering Supplies, and of course, IIHF, the biggest sponsor, and obviously we host this as the IIHF World Championship. So thank you very much to everybody, and we'll see you in about 13 minutes.
Yeah, we've got some highlights on the way, of course, from a very exciting first period of play. Okay, welcome back. Almost time for the start of the second period in this under-18 IIHF Ice Hockey World Championship match. It's Division 3B action. This one, of course, between Hong Kong, China, and Thailand. It's tied at one apiece. I guess that it's a subjective view, but it certainly did look to me like Thailand were putting up quite a fight in that first period. I really gave them a lot of credit. I know people on our messaging platform talking about the fact that really, you know, the socks that you are smoking, Jeremy, is magnificent. But I mean, you know, I thought that they were very composed against the team that, you know, Hong Kong, China have really looked the business in this tournament and have been very impressive. And I bet you, if they were to be 100% honest with us, they were not expecting that scoreline at the end of the first period. No. Now, it might completely go ugly from here, but gosh, what we've seen so far is the makings of a very tough competition.
I agree. I think it's going to be a very tight one, this. I'm hoping it's going to stay tight because it keeps it exciting, keeps everybody on their toes, fighting hard for everything. They're going to put their whole lives and bodies on the line. It's their last game of this tournament, so they have everything to give.
Exactly. They certainly
nothing
have.
Nothing to lose. Well, they have a lot to lose, but...
Yeah, no, they don't want to lose. They definitely want to take away the win. And of course, the other thing is that, as you say, Nadine, it's the last game. They're coming off a rest day as well. So the aches and pains, the couple of knocks that they've had will have recovered in that rest day from yesterday. And they will be good and ready to go and put their very best foot forward in this last game. We're just seconds from the start of the second period. I mean, Nadine Sheffield was saying midway through that first period, she thinks it's going to be a tough game. I thought that Hong Kong, China were going to walk them, not to be. And now, of course, I've got a completely different view on the world. I'm interested to see which is the team that blinks first, which is the team that isn't able to go the distance at the moment. I can't make that call.
Well, look, we're only first period down, one to go, or two to go. I mean... generally in the third period, that's when you see who's got the stamina and who's been training, like all fires fitness and all that. I think both of these teams are super fit. They are all young athletes of men, so let's see how it goes. Hong Kong, China right now making a quick break into the zone and then setting it up straight away. Remember, they're on a power play for like a minute and a half now, so let's see if they're going to get one in and then try and get a security goal thereafter, but we'll see what happens.
Hong Kong, China love to do this.
Nice little
sniper.
He was hit by the Thai guy took him down.
Just looking to see what happened.
Interference there, but it didn't have any impact on the game, so it's all right. Hong Kong, China breaking it through, dumping it up to the top. Great turnaround there by Chung. Oh, they're right in there.
Ooh.
Beautiful clearance, though. Good job.
I mean, there's still, 50-odd seconds left in this power play. Hong Kong, China are not going to get themselves flustered. They will still now rebuild, put themselves into a good position. They will build that platform and strike when the moment is right.
Right. I think they're going to make it happen soon. But I think Thailand are also showing that they are really good at penalty kill right now, and they're keeping it strong. Holding their box really well.
That was an uncharacteristic mistake.
Especially from him. Wong usually keeps it quite tight.
I was expecting that to go pinpoint to the player from Hong Kong, China, and then the shot to come in. But now it's 20 seconds left and still a bit of a scramble. Tell you what, Thailand are not going to fall on their sword easy in this one. They will make sure that they close all of those gaps and work their way through to the end of this power play.
I'm just having a read at a comment. We've got PUBG TJ saying, Turkmenistan is with you, Thailand. Let's go. That's quite cool. So that's the end of the penalty kill for the Thailand team. So now they can put the pressure on and attack again. Wong gets smashed into the boards there a little bit. Not too heavy. Oh, missed pass there.
So something is off here. I can tell you now. Something is definitely off. The body language out of Hong Kong, China, just feels a little bit like they are definitely not at 100%. They're passing in particularly towards the back end of that first period, and now in this second period has been somewhat misdirected. And everybody is allowed to make a mistake, of course. But it's not their usual standard. And gosh, I mean, Thailand almost forcing their way through there. It does look like they are maybe official getting in the way, and then the rest of the team. But it does look like they may be a little bit sluggish. Yeah. And at some point, somebody's going to need to flick the on switch. Because, you know, just to skate around the ice for two more periods is not going to do it.
No.
And I'm not sure what your thoughts are, but they just seem a little bit, they seem a little bit sort of pedestrian.
On the back step, yeah. No, I hear you, and it is looking that way. I think Thailand are putting on exceptional pressure and really showing them that they are not a weak team, but there's a bit of roughness and naughtiness going on here.
Oh, come on.
But it's all clear. There's a shot there that goes down onto the Thailand goalie. But yes, I agree with you. Not as hundreds as they have been in the past couple of days. But again, keeper's keeping it safe.
There's definitely niggle in this game. There's some off the puck action. Guys hitting their sticks and then having a couple of words to each other. So there's a lot of intent in this game. There's a lot to play for, obviously.
Yeah.
Shot comes in.
Oh, kicked out, but he's got a load.
Rebound, and he'll take that back. Thank you very much.
Good job of keeping it down and keeping control of it.
He got his glove onto that one so quickly.
I like his helmet.
You like his what?
His helmet. What did you think I said?
No, I didn't hear what you said. You like his helmet?
Yes, look how pretty it is. It's got the whole Hong Kong, China emblem on the side. It's really pretty. It's like the flag.
Fancy, yeah, yeah.
We don't get such pretty ones here in South Africa, you know? Just plain white. If you really have a lot of money, you can get it airbrushed and stuff like that. The goalie helmets are always beautiful to look at. Here we go.
I don't know what to say to any of those comments that she's just made.
Really?
I mean, I'm just getting used to the rules now. I'm going to talk about beautiful helmets. Here we go. It's an offside.
Yeah. Jeremy's getting there. Lines person, here we come. Have you thanked an official today?
Have I did what, an official?
Have you thanked an official today?
Have I thanked one? I thank an official every time I sit next down to you.
No, not me. I'm not on the ice. Here we go. Face off in the neutral zone. There was one back there by Thailand, but Hong Kong have managed to get possession.
There we go, let's see what's going to happen.
Pops it up to the side. And Wong dumps it down. Daly's going for it.
Oh, through the legs, thank you very much. Thailand looking for a way through. Closed that door, thank you.
Like
by Hong Kong, China.
Trees there.
Wow, are you kidding me? How about that pass?
Beautiful.
And shot comes in.
Quick passes, you see? Quick passes really messes with the goalie. If they pull 1-2 and a quick give and go, the goalie has to move with that puck, and then that's it, they toast.
And of course the first time shot also makes things difficult, because you move with the puck, but then it's coming straight at you a split second later.
It's beautiful to watch. Weird.
Let's see, it's Hong Kong, China who have obviously hit that on button now. A little bit more intensity from their side, but Thailand come away with
it.
Looking for
a
way, just two miscues. I think put a pressure on that second one, but still two miscues. Good backchecking there from Hong Kong, China. Shot comes in.
Ooh.
If he had caught that with his hand again, I would have had to run down to the ice and high five him. It's just crazy.
He's got a quick glove. You know, we were talking about the Turkmenistan guy. We kept saying he's so quick. Did you know that there's an NHL goalie whose surname is Quick? It's insane.
And please tell me that he is, in
he
fact.
He is. His name is, I think it's Jonathan Quick. Very fast. It's actually quite cool. We even have players here in Western Province. His surname is Fast.
Really?
Mike Fast. And he's a phenomenal player. He's actually a foreigner, but his name is Mike Fast.
I like that.
It's okay, very cool. He actually plays a bit of Masters hockey, but he plays in our senior men's league as well. Anyway,
okay.
Back to this game.
When she's not telling us about beautiful and pretty helmets, she's giving us a quick rundown on surnames. Here we go. It's Thailand up the ice and certainly very fast. Shot comes in.
Oh, what a rebound.
No. And they're not going to like that one.
And again, there's the retaliation. Everything was fine until he gave that last one.
Yeah, no, he was really excited about it. And unfortunately, taking matters into your own hands, apparently still not allowed. There we go. Hong Kong, China, number 8, on his way
so
for a little bit of a sit down.
Number 8 cross checking.
Oh, cross checking. I call it something else. But anyway, Ari Liang goes to sit down for a little bit inside the.
It's quite correct. It's a good call. Everything was fine. It was just a normal battle, you know, protecting the goalie. And then afterwards, he came in and just gave him a.
It's free. It's free, and then. Oh,
see,
it's.
There's one.
It's marginal.
And then,
Then again, there
That's
we go.
That's where the penalty came in. So they were fine. He wasn't going to call anything until he gave that third one.
Yeah, that last one was just asking for trouble. Rush of blood to the head happens even to the best of them. Shot comes in. That's a bullet. The keeper had no clue where that had gone. When we see that again in the replay, you'll see that he... Ouch! That's going to leave a mark.
Shots fired.
Yeah.
Thick and fast, they're coming in.
No, exactly. I stand by my... Ooh!
And you see now, it's a penalty kill, and look at them. Pressure straight up there. Hong Kong, China just going in and attacking.
And still it's Hong Kong, China. But Thailand know exactly how to defuse the threat. And so away they come with it. Up the ice. Pinpoint passing, if you don't mind, Lady Sheffield. Shot comes in. And they've timed it so that the oncoming players also cause just that sort of visual out of the corner of the eye for the goalkeeper. So he knows the shot's coming, but at the same time, he knows that their player's coming to his left. He's got to watch for them. Still, Thailand with the setup. And shot comes in.
Ooh.
What on earth? How did he miss that? Somebody obviously pulled in the side of the net.
Well, they hoped to get a deflection too, but
and
no
here
one
we
was
go.
There.
Again, the setup.
Nice pass again.
And shot to come. Ooh.
Shame it. You just missed that one.
Bit of a fresh air. I'm sure that's a penalty.
Hole in the stick.
Okay, fine. And here we go.
The shots are coming beautifully in here by the defenseman.
Talk about using your power play. That's exactly what they're doing. Now they just need to score. Oh, nobody told him that
they
ball.
They need to pull the goalie.
And...
Oh, nope. Just wide of the net again, but the rebound's there. There they come again.
Pouring on the pressure. They want this goal to Thailand. Fiddle, and it's not going to work. In fact, they've weathered the storm. They're back to 5-on-5 now.
Great thing. 11 minutes left in the period. Icing is called off. Hong Kong, China beating the Thai team there.
Good speed there from Hong Kong, China.
Passing it around to his defenseman. Pops it back into him down low.
How was that pressure, though, from Thailand during that power play? Here they come up the ice, literally straight up the ice. Good passing. Composed, looking for the offload. And
Thai team are definitely watching this very, very much. They want to get another goal.
Exhibition. Will he get it? Nope. It's still Thailand passing it. Shot
to come. Beautiful
pass.
And oh, yeah. 13 pats it away from number 25 from Thailand. That was a pretty well-worked game.
I feel like somebody called it earlier on.
That
was just beautiful ice hockey. Let's have a look at this one. You see the pass comes in from 25 to 13 and bang.
Beautiful. That was Chun Hei Marcus Fung who puts it away. And now from number
25.
25 there. Can't find it. Maybe I'm looking at the wrong team again here. Yeah? I'm so sorry. It was Tanat Limpanyakul that scored it, and number 25 that assisted it was Chayapon Jakathorn.
There we go. I mean, it was almost a shot that the goalkeeper didn't want to save, because if he had, you just feel like it was shot with such venom, it would have dragged him into the net as well. It's funny because we had somebody message us minutes ago. I mean, not at that moment, minutes earlier, just saying something about number 13.
There we go.
Giving it the, I don't know.
Peace sign.
Peace sign, and very much a fan. And there you go, goal. 2-1 the score, by the way, folks. It's Thailand, if you don't mind, who are leading this contest. I mean, we did have somebody. Oh, my word.
Fired.
How? Can we have a look at that one again? Because there was no business of that player to be making that shot. And yet he turned it into an absolute rocket.
That puck was super fast.
That was beautiful. It looked like he was shaping to pass. His wrist shape was to pass, and then all of a sudden he fired it in at the keeper. There
face
we go.
Off. Down face in the off. Hong Kong China zone. They've won it back, but Thailand again with the pressure. It almost seems like they're Hong Kong China on a bit of a panic. Thailand have definitely been putting the pressure the whole way through, and they are wanting this.
Yeah,
they are really wanting to win.
They have definitely owned the first 10 minutes of the second period, but here come Hong Kong China, and they just sort of guide him.
He's down. Nothing serious. It was a good check, but he went
flying. I mean, this is ice hockey, not chess. So here we go. Somebody's going to make a T-shirt like that one day, Nadine. This is ice hockey, not chess. And they're going to have to pay me massive royalties. Wow, this is beautiful. I'd love to see that that shot that shouldn't have been a shot. It just looked to me like he was shaping to pass. Let's have a look. You'll see him coming down the ice. Just in a second, let me just do this. Here we go. Looks to me like he's getting ready to pass it, and then all of a sudden, it's a bullet, and the keeper is awake.
Yo, quick hands.
In fact, I think he took it in front of his nose.
Here we go. Thailand in their zone.
Here we go.
One back by the Hong Kong China team. Great
look at that
there.
Pressure. That's what you and I have been saying. Is such a valuable skill to have, to be able to be pressured. All good and well to score goals, but it's to prevent goals being scored
exactly.
That is just as valuable as well.
It's the immediate pressure and being close enough in the vicinity of the player. It was a big check, but very clean, but beautiful check. But if you don't put the pressure, they have too much space to move. They have too much time to think about what they want to do, plan something, you know. It's like having a tea party.
Still, Hong Kong China shot comes in off the elbow of the keeper. I'm sure he's got a whole lot of padding underneath that lot.
Definitely does.
Punched it off. Here come a whole lot of fresh legs as well. Well, suddenly and from somewhere, we are down to 8 minutes in the second period. Somebody needs to explain if somebody's fast-forwarding the clock here. But, wow, we are flying our way through this one.
And look at the shot count. It's 12 to 11.
12
eh?
to 11.
And again, Thailand with the least shots with the higher goal.
And full value for it. Let me tell you now, they deserve that scoreline. Ooh, it's like a whole lot of scuffling going on there inside the goal area for Thailand. It's just high-speed, precision, physical ice hockey at the moment. These two teams go... Oh, my word, sit down. Nothing wrong with that one, I've got to tell you, Nadine Shepherd. Looked okay in my book.
Yeah, I know. Didn't check.
Good vision there, just not able to get it through the traffic. He was aiming for number 8 on the... Thailand, of course, now looking for that extra strike, but it's the pressure coming from Hong Kong, China. Thailand, though, come away with it. Just stymied initially. Here we go. Good pass. Now, passed behind his player. So that one's always going to be a trick. What
shot
to do with it?
Shot count is now 14 to 11, Hong Kong, China. Keeping it in beautifully there. Good job of keeping it down there. But now, quick change in here. Pressure from the captain. Oh, big hit there.
Yikes.
still keeping the puck in the zone.
This is something that Hong Kong, China definitely not accustomed to. They've not had to put up with this at all during this tournament so far, which of course talks to their really good results up to this point. Now they are behind the game and work to be done. Here we go. Thailand on the attack again.
There. Oh, a big tripping trip there. Number 15.
He's also going to be able to...
He's going to go sit for 2 minutes for a trip.
He's going to have a cup of tea made for him. He'll be able to sit down, put his feet up, and relax. Let's have a look at this. Not the most subtle trip as well.
No.
Complete, clear, and let me just trip you up quickly and flat.
That took a skate right out.
There we go.
Ambrose Wong.
Wong, of course, for Hong Kong, China. And it does talk to the desperation from Hong Kong, China. I think they're sort of beginning to realize that this is not going according to plan. This is not going in their direction. And Thailand are now a legitimate threat. Shot comes in. It's a little bit wayward. But Thailand now in with a really good chance of coming away with what I'm going to call an upset win. In this particular encounter, 2-1 they lead at the moment. There's 6 minutes and some change left on the second period. Lots can change, plenty of goals can be scored, and there's still very much an opportunity for Hong Kong China to claw this one back. The question is, will Thailand allow them? And at the moment, I don't think in that mood.
I think they're on the mission here, and I think the mission is working. It's working. They've upset
shot to come almost. Snuck that one in. Now, here we go. This is the composure that I was talking about.
Oh, what a deflection. Brilliant defense work. Now the race
speed
is on.
Speed coming from Hong Kong, China.
Pressure there. Can he put
looking
one away
for a
shorthanded?
Way through, and in it comes. Bobbles over the top. Ooh. Unfortunately, didn't skate or didn't slide on the ice, did the puck. Could have bounced.
It was good pressure by the Hong Kong, China team.
Yes.
Great work there.
On the breakaway, could have been a bit of a breakaway goal, but not to be. Here we go. This is what I was going to talk about, was how they set up for the attack.
Power play.
Look for the platform. Amazing. Shot comes in. Please save. Don't hit that man, because then it's just going to be a fight.
Great work there by the Thailand team. 5 minutes, 13 seconds left.
How did we get here?
Well, he's not here. Where is he, actually?
Oh, that was...
watching?
Sorry, that was... I mean...
I know.
Yeah.
He has... He was there earlier, but he's been pretty silent.
Gosh, this is a really good game of ice hockey, folks. I've got to tell you that the 5 minutes, 13 seconds left on the clock for this second period. It's still anybody's game. Shot comes in. It's an absolute bullet. The only thing it's going to do is upset the neighbors next door to us. Because it's so high. And down it goes. Of course, now icing, because we're still in the power play. Now, Thailand can see. Not fussed. Didn't go where he was aiming for it to go. And it's
quick
up
pass.
The ice. And
quack. Oh, poked away there.
Gosh.
Thailand doing a great job.
I think he held on to that a little bit too long. Maybe just didn't have full control. Now, it's Thailand on the breakaway. 3 seconds left on the power play. They will look to score, and not to be. That one just skates innocently, harmlessly past the right upright of the goalpost of Hong Kong, China. Yeah, they got a chance, though. It's just the goalkeeper to beat, and he swings it wide. Lots of desperation inside that Hong Kong, China team now.
It's
all of a sudden.
Like them. Usually they're precision shooting.
Yes, exactly. Space shot.
Maybe they got too much sun yesterday.
I don't know. Something happened yesterday.
Maybe.
Let's see what's going on. Thailand still making a nuisance of themselves, getting into the faces of Hong Kong, China, who are struggling with this. There we go. Pushed off the puck. Also pushed off the ice. That'd be a good trick. Pushed off the puck. Somehow gets his pass in. Shot comes in. Doesn't control it, does the keeper. It's still Thailand with the puck. The setup comes. Shot comes in. Long range effort. Keeper ducks under it, and it's got plenty of time not to hit it. Now it's Hong Kong, China on the breakaway, looking to come through. The defense comes in for Thailand. Shot comes in, and into the netting, we're going to see ourselves a face-off deep inside the Hong Kong, China, I beg your pardon, the Thailand half of the ice. Okay, let's see what's going on. And face-off, and puck drop, and there we go. Hong Kong, China now have it.
3 minutes, 15 seconds left in the period.
Good skating, though, 14, from Thailand.
14 for the shot count. Are Thailand going to put another one away and get a security blanket? They
can you imagine? Goal.
Hong Kong, oh, he went tumbling.
That's very athletic.
Washing machine of note. Beautiful hand work there by Koo. I think my favorite players of the Hong Kong China team are number 6 and number 3. They've got quick hands. Their ability is just exceptional.
There we go. It's Hong Kong China who have got it. And for the first time in this tournament, their precision is letting them down. They're almost looking like they're struggling to come up with a plan here.
Quick movement there, good movement.
Thailand again at will, just taking away position, and will look for another strike. Bobbles in the puck, keeper can't control it, nudges it out, and it's still with Thailand. Shot comes in, it's a little bit messy.
I love how the poor guy in the back, the goal judge, ducks. He's got two sets of gloves in front of him.
And shot comes in again, out into the netting. The one thing that Thailand will do well to do is to just give themselves a split second more time in terms of taking those shots. The last several shots, I can't even tell you how many, I haven't been counting, but have been high, where in fact just a little bit of steadying, extra bit of steadying, and you might very well have asked more questions of the keeper.
We're under 2 minutes left here. 16 shots now for the Thailand team. So they've overtaken from Hong Kong with China.
I must tell you, no. I was taking a little bit of flack from a couple of the viewers in terms of my assessment of the fact that Thailand are a legitimate threat in this game.
But it's looking more and more true, eh?
I don't think that anybody's laughing now, because, gosh, they have come here with a game plan. They have not come here just to play the last game.
No.
They have come here with a game plan, and their intention is to take the win. But it's Hong Kong, China. They come away with it. Cleared up by Thailand. Good defense. Back-checking is excellent now. Oh, they had a small technical problem. Nadine Sheffield has just put a hand on it, and
enough.
She's fixed it.
Enough.
Yeah, just put your hand on it again. Oh, and the shot to come.
Oh, what a save.
Deflection.
Beautiful
on his
clearance.
Knees. I mean, if
and
you don't mind.
And he clears it out. Beautiful.
And he...
are your foot being on cables?
Am I? Foot's on...
Are you kicking things?
No, I'm not kicking anything. I'm sitting very still. See?
It wasn't my hand of God working. Yeah, it didn't work.
Okay. Okay, let's see. 59 seconds, and it's a face-off deep inside the Thailand half of the ice in the red zone. Let's see what happens. Neat little clearance there. Gives Thailand a chance to just give themselves a little bit more opportunity, a bit more space. In comes the shot. That one, in fact, was a little bit more tricky than it looks, but well handled by the keeper.
Seconds left.
Rob, if it's possible, at some point, maybe in the second or third period, if you could show the
big shot. Beautiful shot. It went over the keeper. Nice agility there by the official. Oh, sliding in. Tyler with a chance. 23 seconds left. Just on 15 seconds left. 5, 4, 3.
There's a lot of sticks, a lot of bodies, and
they just didn't get one in.
Pushing hard. You can see that it's starting to dawn on Hong Kong, China, that this game is not headed in their direction. They have suddenly upped the intensity. They have come to the realization. They've come to the realization that this game could very well slip away from them. That's the last thing they want after two good performances up to this point. But will that be possible? Here we go. This is lots of high fives, pats on the back, and Thailand will feel rightly happy as they go into the break at the end of the second period.
I'm very impressed with that team right now. They are really pushing hard and they're wanting this win. The shot count, 16 all.
Yeah.
But yet Thailand have got the extra goal in, so they've got that. They're going to go the extra mile. I think they're going to come out firing to defend that. Hopefully get one more in as a security goal, and then we'll see. But I mean, Hong Kong, China might come out just like aggressive now and just put all their everything they did in the past two games they've played, they need to bring now.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I think that Hong Kong, China have now got one period left to rescue this game.
Yeah.
And I think that will be part of the message that they'll get from their coach is, what have you done for those first two games? Remember that. Now replicate that in this final period. Let's have a quick look at our... I just want to have a look at this one time. So there we go. You've got Hong Kong, China, top of the table at the moment. Two wins from two outings. Thailand, one win. They've lost the game on the way. And this win will be crucial because it will take them into level on points. The goal difference will obviously very definitely be with Hong Kong, China.
Yeah.
But they will not want the sting of losing.
No.
Let's imagine that it wasn't a strong scoreline, or rather goal difference for Hong Kong, China. They would be in serious trouble right now, other than, of course, that they played really well. They still do not want to lose this game. At the moment, that is the real prospect that they face.
It's very interesting, but I'm going to have a chat as well to the results manager. But at this point, you know, Thailand winning on six, have 6 points as well. We never know what could happen. I'm going to actually just check on that and clarify.
Okay.
But, there's a lot of technical things and different ways that they run through the points to win, to go through. I mean, if South Africa even wins tonight, that's even going to put a new spanner in the works. But let's see what happens. We'll chat to you guys shortly, in about 13 minutes.
Let's do that.
Cool.
All righty then, we're back to the action, and about 30 seconds from now, we'll get that final period underway with Thailand, if you don't mind, leading 2-1 in this game with Hong Kong, China. As Nadine Sheffield says, it's not a foregone conclusion that just because they've got a great goal difference that things will never go their way. We'll have to wait and see. There are a couple of other permutations that need to be taken into account. But wow, what a game of ice hockey. Doesn't matter who's winning here. What a game of ice hockey we are being treated to.
Yes, it is. And it's actually such nice things to see these two countries coming together again, having such skills. And it definitely looks like Thailand wanting to win it, like more than anything. And I think, you know, there's an opportunity for them. They can still take gold, but they have to score a whole lot more goals. So it's going to be an interesting one. We'll see what happens. But yeah, let's see how Hong Kong, China come out firing now. Just want to send a big shout out to Tadamasa Nagayama, who just sent us a little photo saying, how's it, to me and Jeremy. He's one of our biggest fans, but he's also an amazing photographer.
More your fan than mine.
In Thailand. And
Nadine's got fans all over the world, guys.
It's not me, it's you.
All of the fans, people write to her every day.
And the nonsense.
All the time they write
to her. They miss you, buddy. They miss you. Anyway, here we go.
They walk past me in the street, they go, who are you? That's what they say.
Beautiful save there by the keeper.
Okay, listen, we're back to business. And we're deep into this game. And our third period underway now with, as I said earlier, Thailand leading 2-1. And Hong Kong, China, I can only imagine, got a serious bulleting from the coach in the change room. They will want to come away with a 100% record, make no mistake. There's a chance here for Thailand to spoil that party and to spoil those plans.
It's only been 30 seconds, but already so much has happened. So let's just see. Thailand with a big shot, deflected by his own player somehow. But oh!
Whoa! That was closer than you thought.
Close. They've managed to keep it in, but it just pops back out again. And here we have Hong Kong, China with
shot
a chance.
Come in, make no mistake. Good.
Oh, he's just not getting control. The Thailand team are just keeping the pressure on.
Great defense. Wow, really. That one bobbles loose.
Chance.
Open shot here. And where is the puck? Oopsie.
Right in front of this slot.
It's a little bit messy in front of that Thailand goal. Shot comes in.
Oh!
What on earth? Almost deflects off the Thailand player into his own
goal. Oh, we have a broken stick down there.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
What's the ruling on a broken stick? Can you tell me?
Drop it and walk away. Don't play with it. You can get a big penalty
smile
for playing
wave,
with a broken
baby.
Stick.
Smile and wave. So how much is that lying on the ice there, do you think, in South African rand?
In South African rand, a couple of grand, maybe two.
Yikes.
Depending. Depending
of course,
on
it'll
the
mean
stick.
Nothing for the international.
Ooh, that's a big
shot
hit.
Shot to come in, inside, outside,
he
and
saw
pushed away.
There is a penalty coming. I didn't quite see what happened.
We're going to have a look at it again.
The referee is going to call the penalty. We're just waiting to see what he's calling, and that's on number 8.
He spent quite a bit of time in the...
It's a tripping call.
Let's have a look at what it looks like. You can see them come up the ice. 8 moves in.
Oh, he did. He tripped him with his back foot.
Gosh.
I don't know if he had a front foot, but his back foot tripped him with his feet. He's up.
He's up. He doesn't want to get stretched off because that's the end of it. But, I mean, this is the final game.
Seems
Yikes.
To be okay.
He's just trying to work out where he's going to be breathing from, because that was sore. Let me tell you now.
I think his knee is sore. He's dangling his leg, Shane. I hope he's all right. Hope he can recover. Right, so that is number 8 for the Hong Kong China team that's in there now, and that is Quan Long.
Yeah, he's had a couple of opportunities to sit down for 2 minutes in this game alone. Ouch, that hurt. That's number 10 for Thailand, who hobbled his way into the area there. It was Nutapach Panerai. Anyway, we're underway. It's a power play. Thailand will look to...
Ooh,
what
fired.
A shot. Straight at the keeper. Hit him on the pads. Now... good composure. Now, you can hear them calling for it. Shot comes in just past the keeper's left hand upright.
It's a race. It's a battle to get there first, and Tyler managed to get there. Went for a bit of a slide. Right, up to the defense.
GTD. Got it up to 23. He'll take the shot.
Oh!
Miscue.
Shame, just to let you know, the Turkmenistan guys, they never actually received their sticks. They never came. They are lost. No one knows where they went.
Wow.
So they've had to buy all the sticks that they can get their hands on. Crazy. At the moment. Anyway, back to here.
It's still power play, and it's Thailand up the ice. There's still time, 60 seconds on it. Looking for the setup, it'll come to...
Beautiful. Whoa. Shot.
And just not able to take advantage of it.
Goals the displaced.
Goals have been moved out of position, so we'll stop the clock. Well, don't say that ice hockey isn't exciting.
No, it is. It's one of the most exciting sports.
So we have delivered excitement.
He doesn't look so happy sitting in the box there.
No, he shouldn't be happy. Here we go. It's still, of course, power play time, 40 seconds. Thailand will want to use this one. And when I say use it, they'll want to score. Question is, will they be allowed to? Hong Kong, China doing all they can. Probably not the best opportunity they should. Maybe have passed it as opposed to going for the shot. But nonetheless, it's Hong Kong, China now who come away with it. Taken away there by Thailand. Inside, outside. Leaves it behind. And still it's Thailand. Looking to... Oh, deflections all over the place, like a pinball machine. It looks like they may very well have weathered the storm. In fact, it's going to end with the Hong Kong, China inside the Thailand half of the ice. But here we go. Back five versus five now.
Hong Kong, China with a chance.
Great skating. Snaffled away. I don't know if that's a word. Might be a word I
just
about
to say. You've got some interesting vocabulary.
Huh. I know that I do. And here it comes. Shot comes in. Nobody's interested in that one because it's quite a bit outside the left-hand upright for the Thailand keeper. But it's Hong Kong, China. Bit of space. And great. How did they close that down? I mean, there was nobody there. And then all of a sudden he was there. Lots of pressure, lots of frenetic stick waving and hitting of ice.
It's good. It's good. Tussles. Cooked with it now. Big shot.
Comes in and it bobbles free.
No one there, unfortunately, for that rebound.
Massive open space in the goal, but not to take advantage of it. And suddenly, the first 5 minutes have gone. Just like that.
Ow. No. Al's got it, passes it through, oh, but just not quite getting on the stick and controlled.
Yeah, just a little bit sort of behind him to an extent, not able to control it, not able to get full purchase on the puck.
Big collision there.
Speed into each other.
Head first into him.
Oh.
Yeah, look at those hands.
A dragging stick, a bit of a lag there and a bit of a trip up. Still.
The speed of these
it's lovely.
Players' hands is just incredible.
And they're able to generate so much power.
Yeah.
That one's gone for icing.
Number 10's chasing it down, trying hard to beat there so they didn't have icing. But unfortunately, he was just too far away. But he was catching him.
He was chasing it.
And it's a shot wide. The goals have been displaced.
Yep, they've seen it.
Stop
now.
Stop the play now.
It's pressure coming now from Hong Kong, China. They're going to want to get one back because they know how difficult it is to score against Thailand. Almost did it there. Thailand come away with it. They're up to ice. It's a bit of an outnumbered situation. Comes in.
Woo!
And still another one.
They want more. Such precise shooting and
end
passing.
End-to-end stuff. Let me make you very aware of it. Goal attempts on both sides of the ice. Literally within
number
20
three.
Seconds of each other.
There's a charge.
In.
Oh, what a dangle. But it just didn't get control.
Goodness
so
me.
So close. The excitement, I'm sorry, it's just, it's awesome. Hockey at this level is just so nice.
Not able to control that pass. It's Hong Kong, China who come away with it. They are desperate to find that equalizer. Gosh, that 10 would have loved to have gotten hold of that puck straight away. Good dummy and change around. He's through. But it's Thailand looking for a way up the ice. Inside, outside for 19. And
quick shots on the ice. But dealt away there by the number one for Hong Kong, China, and that's Tsi Wang, David Lam.
So here's another observation, is that, you know, what I like is the effortless way that they are able to either pass or take a shot. You can't tell what it's going to be.
Exactly.
You have got no idea. I mean, I'm just imagining that they're in a particular position, so that's when they're going to shoot. But wow, really good skills from both teams here.
Again, look at the Scott counter. I can't even talk.
What did you just say?
The shot counter.
The Scott.
Scott.
I don't know. We hang together, but sometimes I don't know what she says.
You're supposed to finish my sentences.
Yes, no. I'm
get it
to.
Right. 21 yes. to 16 on the Thailand in the lead with the shot
goodness,
count.
I there can't you take go. Her anywhere. No. Okay, here we go. It's Hong Kong, China who come away with it. Nudges it down there.
Quick up. Oh, and it's up in the air.
Good skill there. Looking for a way through.
Great stuff. Went
inside
their way.
A shot to come.
Shut down beautifully there by the Hong Kong China defense.
That is so good. Wow. I mean, great
they
attack.
They're
great.
Picking it up.
They're defense it is up. Amazing.
Yeah, I know. They are. They're very, very strong in the D's. And I don't know. They're in the third period. We're 11, just under 12 minutes left. Hugely offside there by like six guys. Even though there's five on the ice.
You are so hard on these guys.
Anyway, you know, it looks like Hong Kong or Hong Kong China are really like coming back and like.
Definitely.
They're like, no, we're not going to let this one. So let's see if they can put one away and even it up.
I mean, you know, they would have received, I think, a bit of a bulleting at the end of that second period because they were lackluster.
Yeah.
For maybe not the whole second period, but they were lackluster, certainly in the beginning stages. And I think that that's what allowed Thailand in for that second goal. They were just sort of casually skating. Nothing casual about their skating now. Nothing casual about their body language now.
No.
They are on a serious mission. They are putting the pressure on. This is... exactly what we want to see, and it's just a crucial stick in or body in or skate in that causes the interruption of their attacking. And there we go.
And Thailand are having to defend hard because right now they're also like desperate to keep the score as it is. They don't want to let one in. Pressure straight on there, dumping it down in the corner. Owl's on his way to fetch. He's picked it up, looking for his defenseman, but he's just not there yet. They had gone for change. Wong across the ice in the neutral zone.
You can see the 13 for Thailand just telling the guys exactly where to get to, how to close up the gaps, what to do, but it's still Hong Kong, China with possession. They're not in a shooting position at the moment, but they are working their way to. There we go, slip up there, and it's Thailand who come away with it. Now, what to do with it? That one gets dumped up the ice, and it's icing.
Jeremy, I'm going to make an official of you yet.
Yep, I'll be able to call all the icing shots out there, everything else. Okay, let's see, guys. It's all to play for. Somehow we're at the halfway mark of this final period. The final game for these two teams of this IIHF Under 18 Ice Hockey World Championships Division 3B. I've got to tell you, it might be Division 3B, but this is ice hockey at the very top of the game. Two really good teams.
fantastic to be watching.
Hong Kong trying to space now, not able to control it.
Why did he stop? Oh, he's giving the goalkeeper a bit of a warning because he keeps on dislodging the goals. Chatting to him saying, don't push off of it. Oh, that's what I imagine he's saying.
Or maybe he's saying, do you know of any really good movies we could go and watch at the end of this tournament? Yeah, I know a good one.
Jerry.
Not that. Okay.
Pretty much don't think that's what is on his mind right now.
You don't think
so?
Okay. No. Just a thought. Okay, anyway. And it's Hong Kong, China, again, pushing hard. Thailand, weather the storm now to come away with it up the ice. Bobbles all over the place. And still a lot of red jerseys in the mix.
Jeremy, we've just passed the halfway mark of this period. We are just under 10 minutes left.
Can you believe it? There we go.
Thailand in the lead still. Can they hold it?
If they score now.
Oh, beautiful shot
from the keeper. He wore that on his arm. Let me tell you now. Great save. Hong Kong, China. A bullet of a pass. Long range effort. Two comes away with it. And I mean, saved by the Thailand keeper. Up the ice. Beautiful pass. Great vision. Not icing. Let me tell you now. He got there just in time. Sends it back. But it's the red jerseys come away with it. Hong Kong, China. Shot to come. Surely.
Oh!
Not able to get it
tried
in.
Tried so hard, but what a great save. Good defensive work at the same time.
Good effort by the keeper as well. His body was everywhere.
Hong Kong, China regrouping, looking to get one through.
I promise you, somebody is fast-forwarding this thing.
Quick up there, let's go. Let's see what happens. He's got no one to pass to right now. What is the tactic? Delay? Turned around, passed it through, but Thailand managing to get it through.
Just nudging it up the ice.
Thailand with the pressure. Here we go. Thailand picking it up through the neutral zone, but just losing it. Can they hold on to it and get another one? Pops it up, but it went straight to Hong Kong, China. Delhi with it. Delhi making a move. Quick shot there. It's loose.
Oh, my
great word. Work there by the number 19 or 23. Sorry. He's just kept it away, which is great stuff.
Almost like a keeper lost sight of it.
Cool. That was a close one. Great work there by the Hong Kong China team, knowing where their players are.
Yep. Good save there from the keeper. Good shot there from five from Hong Kong China. Great stick work. I mean, you would have thought that he was going to knock it back towards his player. In fact, it knocked it up the boards.
Good pass up. Deflects it through. Somebody out there chasing it. Again, Hong Kong, China is so quick. Their pace has increased in this last period. They've got gas now. Maybe this is what they were saving it for. I don't know. But they still need to get one on the boards to get anything
exactly,
done.
Exactly, yeah.
20 shots to 23. Thailand in the lead with a shot count. Thailand in the lead with the goals. But yeah, oh, tripping.
Wow.
But didn't quite get a call from the ref.
Nothing.
Don't know if it was.
All of the officials, arms down. Happy with the way that one played out. Here comes Thailand. Shot comes in off the gloves of the keeper. It's still anybody's game. It's Thailand that lead 2-1. There's 7 minutes left on the clock. It's certainly Hong Kong, China who are going to have to make all of the work. They're going to have to push the play.
Wang with a shot, but defended there by 22. Now we have
shot
number
12. Into the defender's skates. Not going to score a goal that way. Still, Thailand in.
Oh, beautiful play, but doesn't get through. Beautiful save there by Lam.
Wow.
Hong Kong, China with it again. Four of them on a go. Looking to set it up. Quick passing, good passing. They pulled him, but he's just not got it on his stick. Oh, it's everywhere. It's loose. He's got it on. Now there's a bit of fisticuffs going on. This is what we were expecting for this game. Woo, helmets off. Good work there by the officials to break it through, keep it
there
down.
There is a lot at stake in this game, Nadine Sheffield. Let me tell you now, These guys are not going to roll over and play dead, and I'm speaking of both teams.
Woo! Love hockey. You don't see this in tennis or in hockey.
No, fortunately, you don't see this in tennis at all.
Field hockey? Nah.
Normally. Here
okay.
We go.
Let's have a look here. What's got a lot of fights going on there.
Yeah.
They're still going at each other. They're going to get a misconduct shortly. Referee needs to sort this out. Officials coming over to do it.
I love it.
Linesman taking charge there.
This is a really good indication of the intensity, how much it means to both teams. It's going to be a little bit of talking to. What we're going to do next.
Here's the replay. So he shoots it. Beautiful shot, but misses.
It. Now.
Goalie could have had it if it didn't go up. But here we go.
Here it goes. This is where the trouble starts. In comes the shot. It gets very messy. It's him in
off
the face.
His face. Then they try and get in there.
And then it gets... And there.
Yeah.
He's got his hand on it. And he's still going at the keeper.
And the other guys are at the back already. Officials were trying desperately to break it up. And they did a good job. Somebody ripped that guy's helmet off so hard. Wow. Young blood. So let's see, we've got a lot of calls that are still going to step up and come through. And we are just waiting on the officials to make those calls and it to come. Okay, so it's going 4-on-5 at the moment because we've got two players in the Hong Kong China bench and one on the other bench. Okay, so
still just going to be 4-on-4.
No, 4-on-5. Thailand will have 5 players. And Hong Kong, China will have 4 players. We'll see now what the penalties are being called. They need to just hang on a bit. Number 8, Quan Leung from Hong Kong, seems to have tripping and roughing, so he's got 2 minutes and 2 minutes for 2 separate penalties. That's what's on my stats board at the moment.
So he's got 4 minutes.
Okay, here we go. And then we've got Thailand, Titawat Paratamasku, number 8 as well. All the 8s.
Yeah.
He got 2 minutes for roughing. And I think number 17 is sitting there at the moment. I think he's sitting the other penalty, but we'll just wait and see what happens. Thailand's got a timeout for 30 seconds. Sorry about the silence here. We're just trying to wait for these stats to pull through so we know exactly what's going on. So we've got Tse Long Owen Kwok, number 17, who's also going in the box for Hong Kong for roughing. So Quan Leung is going to be sitting for 4 minutes and the other two players are going to be sitting for 2 minutes. That is why you have a 4-on-5 situation.
Oh, another if it goes amiss there for Thailand as the score remains 2-1 with just under 6 minutes now left on the game clock. Hong Kong, China. They are playing technically a man short. I mean, Thailand could skate around for 4 minutes and that'll be the end of it. And shot to come in.
Ooh, bit of miscommunication there.
Closed him down.
He has a chance. Oh, and again, he
miscued it.
Puck first. 5 minutes left in the period.
Fresh legs on for Thailand.
I almost don't want the game to be over. Is it strange?
Oh, you and the whole of Hong Kong, China, they also don't want the game to be over.
Opportunity here, along with it. Watch these hands.
Shot to come.
Oh, what a save.
Takes it away from the keeper. Takes the responsibility on himself. And Thailand go up the ice. Outnumbering. In comes the shot. Great deflection from the Hong Kong China player. There's 4 minutes and some change left on the game. Looking for a way through. Deflection off the keeper. Did well to get in the way.
Oh, high stick word. There. There's just so much excitement. Jeremy and I are pretty much just speechless watching in awe. Sorry, guys. Enjoying it. Hong Kong, China with a chance. Big, rough, tough. He's going to get a call. Holding. He was pushing and shoving the guy's shoulder with his hand there. So he closed his hand on him. So it's going to be a hold. Number 10 for Thailand. And that is Nattapach Panarai. 3.5 minutes left in the period.
He's going to sit for 2 of those 3.5 minutes.
So it's now 4-on-4. Is it?
No.
4-on-5.
4-on-5 because the other one was not a power play penalty. This is not the ideal situation for Thailand. They're going to need to manage their position. Because they, in fact, are now short-handed for the next 2 minutes. As we head towards the end of the game, a chance for Hong Kong, China. Shot will come in. Nope.
He was actually passing it, but still got intercepted. Thailand doing a great job of defending this penalty kill.
China not interested in chasing that one at all.
But look at the cherry pickers. Pickers. One here, one there. Looking for those outlet passes, the long passes. Ow.
Hong Kong China surely will set with one back. Here we go. And
out
shot
to Kut with a shot.
Off the body of the Thailand player, but enough to get out of danger. Now, again, what to do? Who will get it? It'll go to a red jersey. Set back and long range effort. In it comes. Wow. Great keeping. It was through heavy traffic. Again,
quick passes, give and go.
Bit of a dummy there. Oh my word, he missed his footing there. Still, Hong Kong, China.
Great shot, but
they're
going
to push as hard as they can. And the referee and linesman are in there so fast.
Like lightning.
Because it got very messy the last time. Listen, 38 seconds left on this power play. There's still 2 minutes and 15 on the game. Anything, I promise you, can still happen and probably will.
Yeah, I'm just silently watching in awe here. These, oh.
And dumps down the ice. Thank you for coming. We are short-handed, so we'll watch from over here. Say Thailand, Hong Kong, China. They will love the position, though.
Again, they've got two cherry pickers up high. There's
clean
that long
ice.
Pass.
And now they'll set that one back and then across the ice. Okay, lots of pressure from Thailand.
Great job.
As they knock it back down. They are managing this power play
very,
so well.
Very well. Only 10 seconds left.
Still, though, position with Hong Kong, China. They'll like that. And they'll like the open ice. They're going to look for a way. There we go. Great pass. Now back across the ice. Here we go. And again.
Oh, how's that fancy handwork there?
Great skill. Wow. In and amongst all the rough and tumble, I've got to tell you, high quality ice hockey. Smash down. That will go for icing because, of course, now they are full complement. 119 on the game. Thailand keeper, a I think his stress levels are about as high as they can be.
He's like, please, team. Please. We're fighting a little bit. Get them out of there. Get them out. Just keep getting it away.
Just win the face of knock it down the ice again.
They've played exceptionally well tonight at Thailand. It's a nice result for them,
there
too.
There we go. You saw that coming, and the shot will come in now.
Oh,
just the final touch, eluding Hong Kong, China.
And it's icing.
That'll go icing.
You see, they are playing a defensive game right now. Dump it down, chill. Dump it down, chill.
Yeah, exactly.
1 minute and 5 seconds to kill.
But, you know, it could backfire because, yeah, of course, Hong Kong, China, all that they need, one or two touches to go their way, and then it is a tie ball game. And I know there are no balls in this game, but you know what I mean. Here we go. Exactly what I was talking about. Here we go. Shot comes in. Traffic in the way, and so it doesn't get to the keeper. Still the red jerseys of Hong Kong, China, asking all the question, holding on to the position.
Oh!
Shot comes in.
So close.
Wild. And dumped on the ice. And let's have another icing.
So they haven't changed yet, this group. They're pretty much going to hang it out there for the rest of the game. Hong Kong, China.
They were hoping they could get off the ice quickly. Let's have a look at this. You'll see the shot comes in. Wow, wild one. And that's when everybody was looking for the rebound. And then he spaded it away. Watch that. Well, you didn't see it, but I mean, it was knocked back down the ice. Now, a breakaway.
Oh, almost.
Almost getting through. Thailand trying to put this one together. Still.
30 seconds.
It'll go to Thailand. There's 28 seconds on the clock.
Says Jeremy, in the last 2 seconds, Hong Kong, China score. Here we go. Thailand with the chance. Just my fumbles. 20 seconds. Here we go.
I promise not to say I told you so if Thailand win this game.
Goalie's coming so they can get a six man. 15 seconds. Oh, put it on the net.
It's a goal.
Three. That's the risk you take of pulling your goalie. They've just managed to get 3-1. Beautiful result there for the Thailand team. Yep. Hong Kong, China really trying hard to just get an extra man for that, to get the draw, but he had a bobbling puck to get control of. Player right there, but just places it perfectly.
Oh, that is.
And you see how often those happen where you miss those, and then you get held responsible for the rest of your life. But what a great goal there. Thailand team with smiles on their faces. Hong Kong, China, not happy at all, but you know, they've really come out in this period fighting hard. My hat's off to everybody.
Thailand came in with a game plan. They executed that game plan to precision. They were able to sustain the intensity of play for 3 full periods, not having to ever take a back step. I mean, the worst period was the first one when they came away with a 1-1 scoreline.
And that's
but
it.
Since then, great results.
Wow.
Hugs and high fives everywhere.
Look at how happy they are, Shane. That's their last game for this tournament for both teams. Don't forget tonight, guys. Turkmenistan in South Africa. Half past 7. But wow, I'm so impressed with Thailand today.
Yep.
Really came out fighting hard. They've done exceptionally well. Look at the goalie. He's just ecstatic.
Great effort from Thailand. I felt like this was a slightly different looking Hong Kong China team. They were not on their game tonight, today. It was a performance that they will probably not be able to repeat again because they are such a good team, our Hong Kong, China.
This is
not their usual standard of play.
Very good.
And they just came in here slightly off. Is probably the only way I can describe it to you. They were not up to their high standards. Thailand came in with a game plan that was just frightening and were able to sustain it. They were able to maybe also get under the skin of Hong Kong, China. But for long parts of that second period in particular, I felt like Hong Kong, China were off the boil. They were not firing on all the cylinders where Thailand were able to take advantage of the smallest of small opportunities and to nail away a goal here and there. And at the end, I mean, it's a 30-24 shot clock, which does suggest that the work rate from Thailand picked up massively through the course of the game. 3-1 the final score as Thailand will claim all the points in this particular effort. What are you pointing out there, Nadine Sheffield?
Just the shots and the saves, trying to zoom in a bit here. Hang on a second. Old eyes.
Oh, there we go.
Now we can see.
It does suggest as well that there was a lot of work being done by the Thailand goalkeeper. Gosh, he was on his game as well. He had really good help from his you know, various defensemen, but wow, good performance from him as well. And at the end, as I said, a 3-1 winning scoreline for Thailand over Hong Kong, China.
What an amazing game to watch. That was super exciting. I'm super happy with the outcome. And they're going to give out some nice awards now for the best players of the game. And then also best players for each team. So they get those beautiful Tissot watches that have the IIHF memorabilia on the back of the tournament. So it's really an amazing watch to receive as an honor to be your best player of the team.
China on 1 goal and Thailand winning with 3 goals. This afternoon will be handed out by the president of the South African Ice Hockey Federation, Jason Cerf, and the director of Consular Affairs Overseas Chinese, Chai Chin Wang. Boys and girls, the best player for Hong Kong, China goes to player number 11, Y Sim Ryan Wong, the assistant captain. And the best player of the matchup for Thailand goes to player number 13, Tanad Lim Panayakul. Best player of the tournament for each team. The best player of the tournament awards will be handed out by the International Ice Hockey Federation chairperson for this tournament, Mr. Bob Nicholson, and the Consul General of the People's Republic of China in Cape Town, Yu Wenze. Of the tournament, who will be receiving a watch sponsored by Tissot for Hong Kong, China, that goes to play number 5, Man Hin Tommy Kurt. Boys and girls, and for the best player of the tournament for Thailand, who will also be receiving a watch sponsored by Tissot, for Thailand goes to play number 21, the captain of the team, Thananut Kulthanthorn. Gentlemen, boys and girls, we now ask everyone to please rise as we play the national anthem for the winning team this afternoon. Thailand! Once again, a very big thank you going out to everybody who joined us here, and also to Hong Kong, China and Thailand for giving us such an amazing matchup this afternoon. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we will now be taking a short break as we prepare for the final matchup of this, the International Ice Hockey Federation tournament in the Under 18 Group 3, Division 3 Group B matchups between Turkmenistan and South Africa. That game starting tonight at 7:30.
Well, Jeremy, I'm actually sad that's over because it was very entertaining. I was actually really enjoying that game.
Oh, it was great ice hockey. Got to tell you, great advert for the game. And there was lots of intensity. There was just great skill in terms of the two teams just working their way around the ice. It really was. I keep saying that ice hockey isn't chess, but yet it was a lot of chess-like moves that saw Thailand come away with that 3-1 win. They'll be rightly proud of their performance. Hong Kong, China just on the night, maybe a little bit below par for themselves, and by their usual high standards, they will come away from this tournament still happy, I think, with what they've achieved. And you know what? I think on their worst night, they will not be lacking in any kind of effort. Really good performance from both teams, and really great to have had them in Cape Town for this Under-18 IIHF Ice Hockey World Championship Division 3B. Who comes away with the gold medal? Well, we'll find that out through the course of the evening. But wow, this is ice hockey at its very best.
No, it is. It's been great. I'm going to send a big shout out here to all our sponsors making that possible for us here in Cape Town. And that's Signage Hub, Bloberg Meats, DigiCape, Intro, CFW, Fans, Peninsula Beverages, the Department of Sports, Arts and Culture, Western Cape Government, City of Cape Town, the South African Ice Hockey Federation, SASCOC, Western Province Ice Hockey Association, Sun Grand West, The Ice Station, Red Mountain, Heart FM, Pedigree Media, Graphic Thought Design, TLC Catering Supplies. Ooh, sorry, the girl who was breaking a stick on the glass. Not very good. Anyway, and to IIHF, thank you very much for letting us host these wonderful world champs in this beautiful country. And I really hope to see you all later tonight online. So, Jeremy, from you, are we going to say bye?
We see you later, folks. We'll see you later.
Cheers.